Start the Covington Emerald mission. You'll need to earn enough caps to do so. To learn how to earn caps fast and efficiently, I'll post a link up here as well as in the description. You'll need 15 caps to do this on standard, 20 to do it on hard mode, and then 25 to do it on rootless. The difference between standard mode and rootless mode is 75 more dollars and 500 XP when you wait a full 30 minutes to do the mission. What's interesting here is you seem to get the same amount of gold no matter what difficulty level you do it on, which is why I see a lot of people just going to do this on standard level. Doing it on rootless level will get you the Pacific Union cap, so that's worth keeping in mind, and you can pick up that cap at Madame Nazar for $200. Yes, Rockstar will charge you $200 to get the cap that you unlocked doing the mission. For those of you new to how the pay structures work in Red Dead Online, you get more for the longer a mission takes, for some reason. This is an invisible timer that starts when you start this cutscene here, and it will reset if you die, so you'll just want to reset it to this point again. To give you a practical example with this mission here on rootless mode, when I waited the 12 minute mark, which I usually think is probably the most efficient time to wait, I got 0.32 gold, 825 XP, and 174 cash. Waiting for the full 30 minutes on rootless mode got me 0.48 gold, 1500 XP, and 225 cash. So personally, I don't think there's a huge point waiting around. You'd be much better to finish this mission and start another mission, and you'll make more gold that way. The mission starts with you coming down the Saint-Denis train station, where you have the opportunity to overhear information that might help you choose your plan. The train is going to Valentine, and if you really wanted to, you could just wait for the train to depart, then go up to Valentine and just wait up there. For some reason, when it gets up there, the guards just decide to stretch their legs, but there is a lot of civilians around there, so as soon as you kill a guard, there's going to be chaos, so it's probably not the most efficient way to do this, but I want to make sure to give you all of the options. So there are two different paths that the train will take. It'll either go by roads or else it will go by Emerald Station. You'll learn that key piece of information over here with the guard and the street sweeper. It'll also put a point of information on your map telling you where it'd be a good place to ambush that train in either one. More on that later. The next point of interest that you might want to know is if you go in and talk to the post office clerk. The clerk will tell you the location of three different chests, which will vary depending on the route that the train will take. These chests will contain jewelry and tonics, and it is worth noting that the guards will get aggressive with you if they see you opening these chests. In fact, it's worth noting here that the guards around Saint-Denis are going to get aggressive with you very quickly, very easily if you get any bit too close to them. I've noticed that if I have a slight bounty on me, if I have to replay the mission, that they get aggressive very, very quickly, but I found that wearing my bandana actually negates this for some reason. So if you have one, make sure you have it on when doing this kind of a mission. Another point of interest that you might want to check out is the option of setting off some fireworks. This will cause two of the guards to walk down the Saint-Denis docks to get a better look at the fireworks. That said, I don't really think this is a great thing to do, but it does look kind of nice, especially at nighttime. So for all you photographers out there looking for a nice place to get a photo, here you go. There's also some dynamite and stuff scattered around, which you can see in Eagle Eye, and this essentially you can just blow up. Another point of interest here are the prisoners that are on board the train, but there really is no reason to release these guys. They will just get killed, and as soon as they get killed, it alerts all the guards to you, even if you're hidden. So I just don't do this anymore. The train departure time is actually quite erratic. Sometimes it goes off very quickly, sometimes it takes a little longer. If you alert the guards, the train will go off instantly, so that could definitely be done if you want to just get this done. If you want to try a stealth approach here in Saint-Denis, you'd probably want to be waited until you get out of Saint-Denis before you start killing people. But you also want to make sure that you kill everyone before you get to the first checkpoint on the train, because the guards there will actually see the dead bodies on the train and you're caught. But you could try throwing the bodies over before you get to that point, but I just haven't done that yet, as I found a much better way to do this. But if you're going gung-ho on this is actually a nice spot in Saint-Denis to start shooting, because you're going to be protected on both sides from like buildings and things from just those guards that are going to ride up and start picking you off on horses. Your options of getting off the train if you're doing it gung-ho like this are either stop the train and then have a bit of a shootout until you can get your horse, or another way is just wait till you have a quiet break in the relentless onslaught of the cops, jump off, grab your horse, tonic up, and ride away. By far, the easiest way to do this though is to learn the location the train is going from the street sweeper and the guard, and then go into the ambush point there. You usually have a bit of extra time to grab the first loot box as well, they're just over here in Saint-Denis, and sometimes you have the opportunity to get all three of them before the train departs. Just do it quietly, don't alert the guards, and you should be fine. When you get to the ambush point, just move the wagon onto the tracks and that will stop the train. For those of you who might want to kill the horses so that they can't move the wagon, Well, you can't. It's also worth keeping the wagon in view until the train arrives, because I have had it happen once where the train just went right through. It's also worth noting, once the cards get aggro again, that train is just gonna go magically right through that wagon also. So your first casualty should probably be the train driver if you just don't want that train to move. My personal approach here was the stealth approach I like to do. I like to go from the back of the train. I pick off the guard here who's at the maximum gun first, then I move up and take off the guard here on this carriage. Just double check which way they're looking before you kind of move closer to them also. When you get to the next carriage, you'll just want to make sure you go into the carriage here where the two prisoners are. This is because the guard inside is always looking forward, so you want to kind of stealth up here, get right and close in, and just take him out with your knife. Once he's done, you just want to move up to the next guard here, who could be facing either way I think, but just take him out quietly and move up the train again. It is really useful that the guards won't be walking up and down the train, and it's also quite useful that nobody's going to get out and move that wagon. So you've a load of time just to move up the train slowly and pick off the guards. So that guard there who's by the maximum gun is always useful to take out. On rootless mode, those maximum guns will just kill you extremely fast. So the next guard to pick out is here inside in the carriage. Just pick him out again quietly with the bow. I used to do all of these with the knife at first, but I just found the bow to be a lot easier. As long as you're getting the perfect headshots and you take your time, it should be fine. Next, move up to the trailer and you'll come across these two guards. You can easily pick out the first guard without the other one becoming aware of it. And once he's down, just take out the next one. Moving up the train again, you'll come across another guard in carriage. Just take him out with the bow and you're good to go. It's worth noting there's a lot of health tonics and stuff around that you could be looting while you're moving up the train, but I just don't. The next guard to take out is this one here, who has a perfect view of the blockage on the tracks and still doesn't do anything about it, but you know, Rockstar NPCs online. The next two are actually kind of difficult, especially if you're doing it solo, because you'll want to be fast in the bow. If you're doing this with a posse member, it'll be a bit easier because you can both just line up the shots and take them out at the same time. But on your own, what you kind of want to do is position yourself in a good place so that you can easily get the second shot after you take the first one. So this is where I do it here. I quickly line up the first shot and quickly move on to the second one to take him out before he alerts the guards. And that's it. Once you have that done, you're free to open up the chest and take the jewel inside. Now, this is something that I learned the hard way the first time I did it. There is one guard left, and that's the guard at the train driver area. So the first time I did this, I was so excited that I just jumped off the train, whistled for my horse straight away, and it just got the guards on me straight away. And we're not talking like that one guard, we're talking there's going to be guards relentlessly coming at you, like cyberpunk kind of, out of nowhere, they just all attack you. So it did take me a little bit of time to run down to get to my horse, but well, that's it. Once I got onto my horse, I'm free to do whatever I want and just casually get to the drop-off area. At this point, if you really wanted to maximize the payout of this mission, what you could do is you could pick up the extra chest loot that the train clerk told you. You could also go collecting some Madame Nazar collectibles, as they should be available in this mission also. Your other choice as well is to do daily challenges and make a bit of gold that way. But you always run the risk of doing something silly and alerting the cops. So for that reason, I usually just head up and cash in my jewel. I told you the payouts and structure about the payouts at the start of the video, so you can make your decision now what you want to do. Do you want to just wait around or just cash it in now? But essentially, that's everything you need to know about this mission. I've been pretty thorough in this mission to give you as many options as you want. So if this helped you out, why not let me know in the comments and leave a like on the video. This helps me out with the algorithm. Also, if you have some other things that you think that I missed or that you'd like to share with the community, why not let us all know in the comments. Also, I'd really like to know what your thoughts are on this mission. Do you like it? Do you like it but you think the payout sucks? Are you having problems with it being kind of buggy? I've noticed that the cop aggro seems to be very buggy, as in for the longest time they were just getting aggressive with me while I was just standing there in Saint Denis, wasn't doing anything, and they just instantly start shooting at me. I found that wearing your bandana does seem to mitigate a lot of that, but you still don't want to get too close to them, and if you do, you'll see them walking towards you telling you to get out of here, and that's when you definitely want to get out of there. Do you think the rewards are worth this level of effort to get up all those caps and then to do this mission? Honestly, just let me know your opinions below. Really like to hear it. And that's it. Massive thanks to all the members as always. You guys are awesome. I'll catch you in the next video.